Standard. But before that, let's have fun. So today, I will teach you how to transform standard to general and general to standard form of an ellipse. So let's start with our first example. And for our first example, we have here the given is in standard form. So we are going to transform this equation to general form. But before that, let's find the center of the given ellipse. So as you can see, our center is 2 and 3, okay? Take note, you are going to equate x minus 2 into 0 and y minus 3 into 0. That is why our center is 2, 3. And for our major axis and our minor axis, okay? So, para makita natin yung ating major axis, take note, saan dito sa dalawa yung may denominator na malaki? Again, saan dito sa dalawa ang may denominator na malaki? So as you can see, we have here 9 and dito 4. So, mas malaki ang 9 kaysa sa 4. That means, we have here our major axis a squared is equal to 9. And our minor axis b squared is equal to 4. To find our a, extract the square root. So a is 3, this is our major axis. And our minor axis, extract the square root, b is equal to 2. Our major axis is 3 and our minor axis is 2. Okay? And since our major axis lies dito sa ating x, that means your graph is vertical. Okay? Since our major axis lies on the x, dito yung x is yung naka-square, that means the graph is vertical. So much for that, and let's proceed to our main objective. We are going to transform this one into general form. So the first step that we are going to do, you are going to simplify first, finding the LCD. The LCD, the least common denominator of we have 9 and 4. Remember, our denominators are 9 and 4. So you are going to find the LCD of that one, and that is 36. So we have here 36 divided by 9 is 4. We have 4x minus 2 squared plus 36 divided by 4, we have 9 times y minus 3 squared. All over the least common denominator. Our least common denominator is 36 is equal to 1. Some techniques that you can apply if we have the butterfly method. So what is the butterfly method? We have here, you're going to cross multiply 4 times ito, multiply lang ito, ito siya. You multiply lang ito, ito siya. And you are going to multiply the denominators. Okay, 9 times 4 is 36. Sir, what butterfly? Ano ba butterfly? Okay, so that's the another way of solving this one. If dito na part. Okay? So since tapos na tayo, you are going to cross-multiply and you are going to expand this one. Okay? Expand the x minus 2 squared and y minus 3 squared and you are going to cross-multiply. So you have 4 times, you're going to expand x minus 2 squared and the expanded form, you can use either FOIL method or the binomial expansion. So you have x minus x squared minus 4x plus 4. Again, saan ito kinuha ito? This is the expanded form of the x minus 2 squared. Again, ito siya is the expanded form of ito. Plus 9 times the expanded form of y minus 3 squared, we have y squared minus 6y plus 9. Is equal to cross multiply of 36. So, again, take note, you are going to expand this one, yung mga naka-square, expand them. Okay, so this is now the expanded form. for your comfortability, you can use the your mas madali sa inyo na the way others others prefer to use FOIL methods direct sila. So after this process, distribute 4 times x squared is 4x squared. 4 times negative 4 is negative 16x. 4 times 4 is positive 16. Plus 9 times y squared is 9y squared. 9 times negative 6y is negative 54. Y. 9 times 9 is 81 is equal to 36. After this process, you are going, okay? You are going to combine like terms and follow the standard, no, follow the general equation of our ellipse. So you have 4x squared plus 9y squared minus 16x minus 54y plus 16 plus 81, and this 36, you're going to transpose to the other side, it will turn negative 36 is equal to 0. So your final answer, we have 4x squared plus 9y squared minus 16x minus 54y minus, plus rather, again, minus 54y plus 61 is equal to 0. So this will be the general equation of our ellipse, of our first example. And for our second example, we have here our equation. As you can see, the given is in general form. So we are going to transform this general form to standard form in order for us to find the center, the major axis, at saka the minor axis. Okay? So we have here the general equation transformed to standard form. So let's start. The first step that you are going to do, you need to arrange the terms according to the variable. So you have x squared minus 14x plus 9y squared plus 36y, and you are going to transpose the constant term to the other side. It will turn into negative 49. So the first step, arrange the terms according to the variable. Pagsama-samahin niyo magkaparehas ang variable. After that one, you are going to transpose also the constant term to the other side. And as you can see, the constant term is positive 49. Transpose to the other side, it will turn negative 49. After this process, you are going to factor out this one at saka ito. Okay? You are going to factor out. And for our x squared, as you can see, and for our x squared dito, as you can see, the constant is 1. So, what? Nothing. Walang mag-factor out. So, as is lang po, minus 14x. Yan. Pero, itong 9, itong y squared natin, meron kasi siyang constant na 9. So, you need to factor out. So, you have labas yung 9. Then, ang maiwan, y squared. And, positive 36 divided by 9, you have 3. 3? 4. Again, dito kasi sa ating y squared, meron kasi siya constant na 9. So, you need to factor out this term para easy sa atin mag-completing the square. So, you have 9, then y squared, positive 36 divided by 9, the answer is positive 4y. So, it's equal to negative 49. And after this process, you are going to perform completing the square. Yung plus lang, plus lang. So, you have x squared minus 14x plus blank plus 9 times y squared plus 4y plus blank is equal to negative 49 plus what is the constant of x squared? 1. So 1 times blank plus what is the constant of our y squared? We have here 9. So, 9 times lang. What are yung constants dito? Yung nauna, is dapat same lang din dito. Perform completing the square, x minus minus, what is the half of 14? The half of 14 is 7. 7 squared. 7 squared is 49. So 49 din dito. Plus 9 times y plus. What is the half of 4? The half of 4 is 2. 2 squared is 4. So you have, simplify this one, negative 49 plus 9 times 4, the answer is 36. Okay? After this process, you are going to divide, both sides by 36. So bakit i-divide ko siya ng 36? Diba? Our standard equation of our ellipse, we have here, the standard for x minus h squared over a squared plus y minus t squared over b squared is equal to 1. So it's either b ang mauna or a ang mauna. So it's depends sa equation. And 1 kasi ito. So you need to divide both sides by 36 para 1 na lang yung iwan dito. So you have x minus 7 squared all over 36. Yeah, diba? May 1 dito, may invisible 1. Siya may invisible 1. So that's still 1 over 36. Plus 9 over 36. Diba? 9 over 36. Simplify this one. That is 1 over 4. Okay? That means y plus 2 squared over 4 is equal to 1. And this is now the standard equation of an ellipse. And what is our center? Our center, equate this into 0. That is 7 and negative 2. And for our major axis, a squared. And for our minor axis, b squared. So as you can see, sinus kanilang dalawang mas malaki, the 36 or the 4. Again, sinus kanilang dalawang mas malaki, the 36 or the 4. The answer is 36. So our major axis, we have here, a squared is equal to 36. Extract the square root. So the value of our major axis is 6. On the other hand, let's have our minor axis. Our b squared, since b squared siya yung mas maliit, so the b squared is equal to 4. So extract the square root. So b is equal to 2. Okay? So again, para mahanap yung major axis natin, you are going to choose sino sa kanila dalawa mas malaki. The major axis is the larger one, and the minor axis is that. Smaller one. Okay? And as you can see, our major axis lies on the x axis. So that means the graph is vertical. So that's all. This is the process in transforming general to standard of our ellipse.